to an earlier point I made, but in terms of the changes that happened this year, there was a lot of changes, and there's a lot of different turns that our bill went through. We stuck through as a group, and we had conference calls and meetings, you know, from at minimum once a week, sometimes it was once a day, and it was very, very important. I've never had the ability to have those because we didn't have as many people involved many years ago, but this time I think it was our best weapon was a unified understanding of what the issues are, because when we're all individually going out and meeting with legislators, they're hearing one voice and they're hearing our concern. Our concerns may all be in line with each other, but if we're not sending the same exact message, it's confusing because the ticketing business, the ticket industry is really not very well understood. It's a very likable consumer issue. People like to talk about tickets. It's a hotbed issue. It gets a lot of press attention, but ultimately, people don't understand it. I mean, even, you know, a lot of people don't understand. A lot of legislatures, politicians, when we go up and talk to them, they don't understand what paperless tickets are. They've never heard of them. They don't know what the resale market is, and they don't know what the ticketing industry is really all about. So having one unified voice, having one approach to discussing the issue, it makes it more understandable to more politicians and